If you are lucky and your neighborhood has a lot of those mature nut-bearing trees like the big giant oaks, chances are your neighborhood also has a lot of gray squirrels.
And occasionally you might notice a gray squirrel that isn't necessarily gray. But is that a sign of disease? News 8's naturalist Jack Hubley answers that question in tonight's Wild Moment.
If you have oak trees, you have gray squirrels. And if you have oak trees and bird feeders, like it or not, you have even more gray squirrels. And then there's Flo Drugan in Mannheim, who has gray squirrels that aren't gray. She writes, "I have different color squirrels in my yard. Do you have any idea why this occurs?" Some areas of the state do have good numbers of melanistic or black gray squirrels, and white gray squirrels can pop up in any population. But I have to admit that Flo's squirrels really had me stumped. One squirrel appears to be white on the back. But look closely, you're actually looking at skin color, since most of the hair is gone. Another squirrel appears to be wearing a black blanket. Flo and I sent the pictures to two biologists, and we got two different answers. Flo's expert attributed the condition to a fungal infection. My contact was Mike Steele, a mammalogist and squirrel researcher from Wilkes University. He suspects that both these squirrels have mange. The variation in color is due to different stages of the disease. One squirrel appears to be white because its hair is gone. The black squirrel is recovering, and what we're looking at is a black undercoat growing in. Fungus or mange, both these maladies are contagious, and their occurrence is often the result of a high squirrel population. This, of course, is one of the downsides of feeding wildlife. Artificial feeding not only encourages population growth, it also brings lots of animals together into a small area, increasing the risk of spreading highly communicable diseases such as mange. That's not to say you should stop feeding birds or squirrels, but if you do notice abnormalities in your local squirrel population, it might be best to throttle back on your feeding for a while. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Mange can be a serious life-threatening disease in some mammals, but full recovery has been observed in many gray squirrels.
Once again, if you've got a wildlife question for Jack, email it to news8@wgal.com.